Hello, I am Dr. Krishna, presenting to you a case of right frontal tumor who presented to us with focal seizures. This is a 40-year-old man who had recent onset of left focal seizures starting from the face, spreading to the hand and left leg, lasting for about 5 minutes and lapsing into generalized tonic-clonic seizure and loss of consciousness lasting for about 15 minutes. And he had two such episodes in the last 1 month. And upon investigation with an MRI, we would see the picture of the MRI here. And the MRI showed here fairly large lesion involving the right side of the posterior part of the frontal lobe, predominantly the cortex and the subcortical region, as we see here in the coronal picture, that is the superior posterior frontal gyrus right in front of the motor cortex. This is apparently the rolandic fissure on the opposite side, and this is the motor cortex, and this tumor is abutting the motor cortex, and this is the T1 flare image, and sometimes it is appearing partly. Whether it is abutting the motor cortex or is just the rolandic sulcus is compressed is not very clear from the MRI pictures. These are the coronal images, and it is showing infiltrative nature of the lesion, but more or less confined to this the pre-rolandic gyrus. In this patient, the MRI features are suggestive of probably an infiltrative glioma, which is the cause for his focal seizures, which is turning into secondary generalization. Here we need to do surgery, that is craniotomy, for two reasons. First, to establish the diagnosis, and secondly, to excise the lesion itself. However, routine craniotomy is not very easily done here, because patient is having a tumor which is very, very much in proximity to a vital structure like the motor cortex. So, there is possibility that during the surgery, the damage to the motor cortex would be very high risk. So, for this, a technique, a special technique called the awake craniotomy is done, wherein the patient is the whole procedure of craniotomy is done under local anesthesia with the regional blocks of the scalp and the dural anesthetization, followed by neuronavigation technique, wherein we can precisely localize the tumor as per the guidance given by the MRI. And during the entire procedure of craniotomy and tumor excision, patient is kept awake, and certain portion of the motor cortex is when we are touching the cortex to know, understand whether we are disturbing the normal functioning, we will be checking the patient's neurological function, especially the motor function and the conscious level throughout the procedure. By that we can avoid damage to these vital structures, and that is what we call awake craniotomy. And by doing so, we can preserve the vital brain structure. And today we will be taking you through the procedure itself. Let us see how we do the procedure today.
He is being given local anesthetics to block the nerves which supply the scalp. As you know, the structures which are sensitive to pain are the scalp structures. And once we infiltrate, the nerves come from the front, the supratrochlear and supraorbital nerve from the front, predominantly the coming from the first division of the trigeminal nerve, and we give the block all around the local anesthetics, then the scalp itself is desensitized. And this local anesthetics acts for about 4 hours. And next structure we need to, once this is anesthetized, is the dura. And that will be, as we proceed, you will we will see how we desensitize the dura. Once we desensitize the dura, then we don't have any pain sensitive structure inside the dura. As you know, the brain itself is not sensitive to pain. So this is only the initial phase. Patient is very much conscious, he is just getting oxygen through the nasal prongs. And this is the only part of the procedure which is painful, like any other surgical procedure which we do under local anesthesia or regional anesthesia, till the anesthetist agent starts acting. And he will be soon comfortable with it. And as you know, the anesthetic agent itself is acts like an initially irritant to the nerve wherever we inject. So it will be and it is one of the indicators that you are very close to the nerve immediately during and after the injection.
ಕೈ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹಂಗೆ ಉಜ್ಜದಾ ಇದೆ ಸರ್,
ಜೋಂಬರದ ಹಿಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹಿಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅಷ್ಟೇ.
ಮೇಲೆ ಮೇಲೆ ಹಂಗೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ಅದೇ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅಷ್ಟೇ.
ಬಾಬು, ಡು ಯು ಫೀಲ್ ದ ಪೇನ್?
ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್.
ಜ್ವರ ಹೇಳಿ, ನೋವು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗತ್ತಾ?
ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಹೆಂಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲ್ಲ ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಗುಡ್. ನೌ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೋ ಅಹೆಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ದ ಪಿನ್ಸ್.
ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪುಟ್ ದ ಪೇಷಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಲಿ ಹೆಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ skull frame. This particular frame what we are using today is called Sugita head frame, named after the famous neurosurgeon from Japan, Kenchiri Sugita. And it is absolutely essential to keep the patient still without even a millimeter of movement for many reasons. So intraoperatively we do not want any movement so that the surgeon is not disturbed. That is the first purpose. So even when we are doing the procedures under general anesthesia, we prefer to use a skull fixation devices like this.
Hello sir.
Relax madi, aaram nidre madi.
Ha sir, sir, sir. Nee em helthira ankel sir. Aayta,
aayta. Very good man.
Illoru sir,
correct madi sir.
This is the intraoperative monitoring station for what we are using here for navigation is the Medtronic stealth station. This is the monitor, and this is the computer, and this is the computer eye, the camera, which has got a infrared light through which there's a tracking be done. We know exactly how we are going to do soon. Patient's MRI or CT scan is done with a specialized kind of sequences which is fed to this computer directly, and then we get a reconstruction of the image what we want. Now this is the total reconstruction of the patient's face itself, which is very essential for us. And then we get different views. This is the coronal, this is the axial, and this is the sagittal image. And then this is the first stage, and it can also give us a 3D picture of the whole tumor. And in this particular case, we are delineating here, as we are seeing this bright signal in the flare sequence is the tumor, which is very close to the motor strip. This is the motor strip, as we have identified from the corresponding side here, and it is abutting the motor strip on the right side. It is in the premotor area, as we already discussed. This is makes very essential, and we are at doubt whether at some portion of the rolandic gyrus is also being infiltrated abutted by the tumor itself. So while excising, it is very essential that we need to preserve the motor cortex as well as the fibers. So this in real time is going to help us to track where exactly we are while we are operating. So that is the purpose of this neuro navigation. His local anesthetics has started acting under the influence of anesthetic agents. He has been put on a skull frame. As you have seen, there is a 3-point fixation. His skull is absolutely still, there is no movement. And now the reference frame for the neuro navigation device has been fixed. And the next step would be to do a patient registration in this position. Now, how the system works is, the patient as a whole with the frame is going to be registered into the computer, and which is going to correlate later with the set of MRI scanning we have already done. And between the two, it gets a tracking system, just like the GPRS tracking, satellite tracking system as we have for the vehicle movements in tracking the various places geographically. Local anesthetics has started acting, and what Dr. Ajay is holding in his hand is the blunt tip probe, which has got the diodes here, which are recognizable by the camera eye. And now first he is going to register with the frame, and the probe is registered as it is indicated, and then the computer is guiding us that this is the first point to be registered. So that is registered. The next point is automatically shown as the glabella, and then the left supratrochlear region, 3 cm away from the midline. Now set of points are going to be recorded, which are essential for the tracking system on a continuous basis. As you see, the bony prominence around the orbit, the maxilla, the nasal bridge and the frontal bone are all going to be covered, which are fixed bony prominences, and some areas of interest near the craniotomy site, which gives a sufficient clues. Roughly about 600 points is what it requires to give a reasonably good amount of tracking points. Basically, this image is reconstructed from the MRI image. So if this image is exactly correlating with what we are showing on the surface of the patient, it amounts to the same that whatever image we are going to on the surface is going to correlate with the MRI scanning. For instance, now it is showing us the lateral extent of the tumor. This is the point where he is showing, he points to the lateral extent of the tumor in the coronal plane. This is the scalp flap, and maybe we'll be placing the burrows 1, 2 and 3 and do a craniotomy like this. So we don't expose anything extra, but we are going to expose exactly what we want, because especially here we are doing under regional anesthesia, wherein we cannot afford to do luxurious incision, we cannot afford to do luxurious exposure, and we have to minimize. And another important thing is, Dr. Ajay, can you point out the midline? We are into the superior sagittal sinus. We are very conscious of the fact that superior sagittal sinus is right under the bone, and we have the bridging veins coming over there. So we have to be careful of preserving these veins during our craniotomy and also during our dural open. We start seeing some veins coming crossing here at this level. So we already planned preoperatively that how to circumvent these veins, because they are very essential. On the scan, it appears that this is the motor strip on the right side, and the tumor may be just abutting or partly infiltrating the rolandic fissure here, and rest of the tumor is in the premotor area. We have another equipment. It's an operating microscope. The speciality about it is a semi-robotic device. It has many components. This is the microscopic head, the major microscope, and this has got the lens system, which has got a varioscope, which varies focal length from 150 to 400. We don't have to change the lenses here. It automatically changes like any SLR camera, and it has got a built-in fiber optic